Hi YouTube, Neil here with Facelift Interiors. Welcome back to our channel. So in this week's video, we're going to be showing you how to cut and sew for upholstery. I know we've been through a lot of time to how to upholster, so this time, by request, we are going to be doing some cutting and sewing on an old wing chair for a customer of ours. So we're going to take each piece apart and show you how we flatten it out and how we cut it, how we mark it, and then how we sew it. So as always, if you like upholstery tips and tricks, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Hit that notification bell as well so you see every time a new video comes live. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to give us a like and drop us a comment. So this is how you cut and sew for the upholstery process. Action! So in this video today, guys, we're going to be showing you essentially how we would cut and sew this chair. So this is going to be a guide to cutting and sewing and your kind of cutting plans. With something like this, the first thing I would probably do is my biggest cuts first. I normally always, that's my standard procedure. Biggest cuts first, so inside back, outside back, they're going to be your biggest cuts. Then you'd probably go inside arm, outside arm, seat, wings, and then your cushion. With this, I can literally just measure. I'll be able to measure side to side on the inside back and the top to bottom and cut that. And the outside back will be the same. It'll just be a square cut. But the arms, so these are called return arms. Might be called something different in other countries, but here where I learnt, it's been called return arms. So you can see here that the outside of the arm comes around, so they sort of wrap around each other. The inside arm comes over here and the outside arm comes around here. It's very important that you copy this and get this shape right. There is a way of doing it from scratch, but I'm going to just show you how to copy this today. So what I will do is make a mark there, and then here, so that's the two corners, corner, corner. So as long as I make these marks on my new fabric, make sure they line up, that arm should fit perfectly. So what I'm going to do now is remove the inside arm and the outside. Well, I'm going to start stripping the chair down. I can't just take the inside arm off and the outside arm off. The whole chair's got to come apart first. But I'm going to show you how to cut this inside arm and this outside arm and sew it back together and then fit it back on. So this is our inside arm and outside arm. So I'm going to start unpicking this. Sometimes with old stitches, you can do this once you get started and pull them apart and just snap the old stitches. Snap them, I say. Oh God. So you can see how old this chair is by the dust that came out of the bloody thing. So you can see here that the piping is sewn onto the outside arm, and then the outside arm is sewn, or the inside arm is sewn onto the outside arm. So that's probably what we'll do. We will copy, okay? So here we have Old Faithful. So we're just gonna flatten out this seam. So this is our inside arm. We are just gonna copy this. Right, remember, our nips are here and here. We need to copy them exactly where they are. One there. And one there. That is our inside arm. See, you've got a fly here. See what they've done here to save fabric. They've put a fly on, just sewn an old bit of lining fabric on, or an old bit of velvet on the bottom to allow for pull down. But I've got enough, I know that. So that is our top inside arm.
So what I'm doing now is I've just taken the panel that I've already cut, flipped it over, and copying it for the other side, making sure I put the nips where the other ones are.
That's another inside arm. Top inside arm. Now we're going to start cutting our outsides. We'll probably get two out of a whip, which is cool, because the more you can get out, if you can get another one out of that side, the better, the less fabric you're going to use. So here is where we need to flatten the seam out, make sure we follow the shape, make sure we copy our nips as to where they need to be. One there, one around here. Now that is top outside arm.
And we are going to need to run up some piping.
So I've worked out I need 372 inches. So I'm going to measure from that down to there, because obviously you want your piping to be as long as it can be, so you have minimal joins. So that is 97.
So 372 divided by, so let's say 400 divided by 97. So I'm going to do 5 strips just to be safe. So with my chalk, I'm marking up my piping. So what I'm going to do is just cut this out. Now what we can do is, now the angle's cut, gloves on, arms protected. One, two, three, and one more, five. Now all I'm gonna do now, make sure they're all marked, same end. Right, so that's our piping cut. Now we can start stitching. So what we're gonna do first is line all of our piping up. So our piping, we've cut it all, so we wanna make sure the way we're sewing it up is all the same way. So I'm gonna go that in first. So do you remember we marked them earlier? So that pencil mark is here. So it needs to be the same on the next piece. So the next bit I don't want the pencil mark. So they are both running the same way. So what we do here to join these two up, so what I'm gonna do is lay one on top of the other like this. Then I'm gonna sew straight across there. So when they join together, I've got a nice clean line like so. So you're just laying that on top of there. Then make sure you do your back stitch. And that is a great piping joint. So now we simply get a pair of scissors and we snip away that excess. And same again, we're just gonna keep doing that. So now we're gonna run up our piping cord.
We've already got our piping foot on. So what I do is I lay it in like so. Use this hand here to tuck it in, pinch it over, and then I hold it there like so. And then both hands and start stitching.
Apologies for the slight jump. What we're doing here is we've just started to attach the piping onto the outside arm.
So as we come around the curve, guys, what I'm gonna do is put some nips. So I'm nipping up to this point here. So it gives us, the piping will sit a lot nicer on the curve. So as you see me sew round. So as you can see here, I'm pulling this fabric round and then laying this piping on top. Right guys, so as you can see here, these are my two nips. These are my two nips here. So what I'm gonna do is line this up here. So I'm not going to start back there because I don't want my nips to move. So I'm going to start here. So then we're going to go back to this point and start here. Right, so this is our inside arm, outside arm, guys. You see I've put loads of more felt on the arm and padded it up. Just turning the arm the right way round. Gonna make sure the selvage is facing down. Just gonna start putting this on. So you can see the return comes round the front.
So we're just gonna do a run through of how the arm goes on once it's sewn together. You've seen us do this many times, but I'm just gonna talk you through it. So I've stapled the back off, then made the cut up into the front, pulling the front piping down nice and tight and stapling off, then cutting around the rails on the inside arm. Then I make a cut into the back of the arm, pull all the fabric through nice and tight, pull the inside arm fabric under. You'll see me pulling that through now. Then I'm going to staple off. You can't see that there, but I'm stapling off the inside arm. Now we're pulling the fabric down nice and tight and stapling off the outside arm.
So next is the seat. On this one, it's like a park and old chair, so it's got like loose springs that you can take out. But what I'm going to do is strip it down and see if I can upholster straight over that and have a nice, just a nice normal seat. This front here, sometimes you can just measure this and just round the corners off, but that is quite a severe curve. So what I'll take is I'll take this apart, I will copy this panel. Bottom panel is just going to be one long piece that's long enough to staple round. So I'll take this piece apart and copy it. And then once I get underneath, I can see if I can upholster over these springs. If not, what I'll do is I'll probably sew this bit together and I'll sew a platform onto here. So I'll make a platform. And a platform is this fabric, but it will have some foam inside it. So it'll be nice and padded and supportive, and it'll just lay on top of the springs. So I'll make that decision once I get into it and I can sort of know where I'm going with it. So finally, guys, use your front border here. That is just going to be a square bit of fabric. So I'm going to cut that 5 inches, so I've got plenty, because I don't know how far up that goes under there. So 5 inches by 24 inches. So here is our seat. So under here, you've got these springs. They are removable, but they're okay. So they don't really need tightening or anything. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to build a platform on top, because before it was just like a loose bit of fabric. It wasn't very good. So what I'm going to do here is see my Hessian. I'm going to use Hessian, which gives us a nice strength, and staple it off around the sides. Then we're going to put some half inch over the top and build the half inch up to here. There's like a line here. We're going to do half inch up to here. Then we're going to put a half inch border on the front. So I'm just going to start stapling that off now. Prepped up my platform. I'm just going to make my seat up.
So we're not going to show you the whole process of how we do the seat, because you've seen us do it many times, but we're just going to stick some half inch blue foam on top and half inch blue foam on the front.
So now we are cutting our panel. As you can see here, that is our template. I'm just going to copy it. Nip the middle at the back. 8-inch border, so I'm just cutting an 8-inch strip. Nip your middle, mark your top, that'll go on there and sew round. Lining fabric, I'm gonna go the same length as that, so that is 31. Again, fold that in half, make your center mark. So that is going to sew onto there, like so. But we also have to put a facelift tag on it. So I'm just going to put a couple of staples in there to hold it all together.
So here I'm attaching some black plastic webbing, and we use it to lash the seat in.
So we sew that in one line, and then we'll sew the border on the front. Right, so, like I said, now we line our next part up, so join to join. So on the other side, where we started, we're going to carry on from there, but this time the border's on the bottom. You can see how I pull this round, so pulling this bit of fabric round, letting the machine do the work, but also I have to do a little bit. Lift your foot if you need to manipulate the fabric at all and move it. Now all I'm going to do is I'm going to sew some flyers onto here, and it's going to go from here around to here. Gives me a nice finish. We don't even have to use a lot, it just needs to be enough to tuck down. So I'm going to use this bit here. So I'm just going to sew that onto there.
Right, let's go and try this on.
So now we're fixing the seat on. Do apologise here that the camera cut out. Didn't tell me, but you've seen us do this many times, and we'll leave some videos in the description of the full upholstery process. So here is the finished product. We previously uploaded a detailed video on how to do a box cushion, so we'll leave that in the link above. The inside back, outside back and wings didn't require any sewing, so we haven't included it in this video. But if you would like to see that process, we will leave a video in the description below. Thanks for watching.